Hi, Ross here, your expert at all things moving. When moving to New York City, one needs to answer a lot of questions before he can be ready. What to visit and explore. What area to choose to live in? How should one approach getting into such a big city as New York?
New York.
New York!
Let's find out in this episode on what to do before moving to the Big Apple.
Moving tips!
Number one, research the city. You can use a variety of sources information. For example, a travel guide, an official website of New York City, and other New York newspapers and trip advisors. The link to those will be available in the description down below. Number two, visit the city and explore. Everybody knows that New York City consists of a couple of boroughs: Bronx, Staten Island, Manhattan, Brooklyn, and Queens. Make sure that you find time to visit them all before moving to New York City. Visit a local grocery store, a cafe or a restaurant, and if you're brave enough, start a conversation with a random New Yorker. Ask them about positive and negative things of staying there. Test out the job market in New York City. They say that everybody in New York City at any point of time is looking for one of those three things: either a place to live, somebody to be with, or a place to work. So make sure that you scour some websites like LinkedIn, create your resume and post it online, and also take time to go to some possible job interviews. Keep in mind that you will need to pay the travel expenses, and of course, make sure that you find something that is suitable and best for you.
Moving tips.
Choose an area you want to live in. After careful consideration and visitations and probably landing a job offer in New York City, now it's time to find a place where you would like to live. Of course, the biggest factors when choosing your apartment in the Big Apple would be your place of work, the availability of public transportation around you, and last but not the least, calm atmosphere. You would not want any crime on the streets near your apartment. Prep, pack, and book movers. After you've done everything that we have just discussed, got an idea about what New York City truly is, found a job, and found an area and a place to live, now it's time to actually get there. Make sure that you take quotes from at least three different moving companies before going there. Of course, be attentive and careful with your paperwork and your belongings. And good luck with your move. And last but not the least, and very specific and unique only for New York City, accessibility. Before your moving truck arrives to your new place of living, make sure that you find a parking spot. Most of the streets in New York City, especially in Manhattan, are very narrow. Sometimes in order to park, a truck will block the whole road. So make sure that you find out all the details about this and do everything possible to avoid that and ticket fines as well.
Moving tips.
Talk to your leasing manager about the accessibility of your building. Most buildings in New York City have two types of entrances: the usual public one and a service entrance with service elevators if it's a multi-story building. Those are usually used for deliveries and those moving needs of yours. So make sure to ask the representative, be it a superintendent, leasing manager, property manager, or anybody who will have answer to that question. Additionally, be very attentive in choosing the time frame for when your movers will arrive. Remember, some managements in most of the buildings of New York City actually give out an access to the service elevator for a quick time span of 2-3 hours. If your movers by any chance will be late and will not be able to get into those hours, there is a chance that you might not be moved today.
Moving tips.
In conclusion, New York City is a giant conglomerate with the biggest opportunities in the world that come with the hardest challenges. So make sure that you follow our tips, get everything prepared, and good luck and welcome to New York City.
Moving tips.